With all of our pieces cut, we began the process of joining everything together using wood glue and dowels. We picked up this dowel jig to make sure all of our holes lined up with each other. This process was a lot harder than we thought it would be. It took about 2.5 weeks of gluing, clamping, drying, and making sure everything stayed at 90 degrees. It took a bunch of clamps and a lot of patience. With most of the big pieces of the credenza and the desk put together, we moved on to edging, which is the process of taking a real wood veneer and gluing it along the plywood edges to hide its layered work. You can buy these in rolls that match your wood species that come with an adhesive on the back. Here's a few tips I found helpful for the edging process. Use a really hot iron to melt the glue from the veneer onto the plywood. Buy an edge trimmer and a flush cut plier to quickly trim off the excess edging. Then break the edges with sandpaper to soften all of your corners and to blend everything together. To prep the surfaces for finishing and to smooth all the imperfections out, we sanded everything down using a 220 grit sandpaper. While most people hate it, this is one of my favorite parts. To see something go from rough to smooth is so satisfying. To finish the wood, we use this natural oil wax blend. We applied two thin coats using a non-abrasive pad. This tinted the wood a few shades darker, brought out the natural textures in it, and gave it a protective coating for use. Once the finish dried, it was the moment of truth, mounting everything to the wall. First, use a stud finder and marked all of the posts with tape. We designed the desk and credenza to mount with a French cleat, so it'd be much easier to level and align everything. We drilled the cleats into the studs first using cabinet screws and triple checked if everything was leveled. Then we lifted the credenza and the desk to sit on top of the French cleat. They almost fit together, but needed a little light hammering to get it all snug. Once in place, we screwed the top part of the cleats in to lock everything on the wall. We then installed a few shelves above the desk, using these heavy-duty brackets and cuts of the same plywood we used for everything else. With everything mounted, we moved on to installing the shelves inside the credenza and the hinges on the doors. I thought we had already gone through the hardest part of the project, but getting all of these pieces to line up and close properly took several attempts. It even required shaving down some of the edges and resetting the hinges. Eventually, we got it all to fit. We then moved into installing these beautiful black knobs on all the doors. This gave everything a nice black accent. To power Belinda's devices, we installed this power outlet on the surface of the desk for quick access. We also cut out a hole for this grommet to run cables down to a hidden surge protector inside the credenza cabinet. With the main build complete, I did one more pass of sanding using plain printer paper. This is a woodshop technique I learned from my friends over at Grovemade. They use this to finish all of their wood products, which gives any wood surface an ultra smooth finish. With the build out of the way, we shifted our focus to organizing the space. We took inventory of both the sketchbooks, tools, and crafting materials, then organized them using stackable plastic drawer bins. We originally got these from Muji a few years ago. They're a great way to make the most of your vertical space. As we started moving Belinda's stuff into the cabinets, she realized she had so many pencils and various types of mediums that she needed to organize in a smart way. So she drew up some plans and decided to build a drawer with customizable dividers. We took a trip out to Home Depot and bought a few sheets of poplar wood to construct it. 2 days later, she had a drawer designed specifically for all her stuff. On the desktop, Belinda has an iPad for her digital drawings and a Surface Book 3 for her design and 3D work. This sits on top of a beautiful felt pad by Grovemade, which can slide out of the way quickly if she needs to clear her desk. When the devices are not in use, they tuck away neatly inside this pull-down drawer. If you want more organization tips, I created a whole video about my process, which I'll link to in the description. The last part of this project is styling the space. I didn't mention it earlier, but prior to mounting the desk, we put a fresh coat of paint on the wall. We used this classic colored paint by Claire in an eggshell finish. This brightened and warmed up the room and was the perfect base color to complement everything inside. Above the desk, we decorated the shelves with Belinda's books, trinkets, and sketchbooks. To personalize the space, we put a few pieces of art in repurposed frames. We displayed some of Belinda's original works, as well as a few pieces from other artists she admired. If you want to put up your own gallery wall, I recommend laying everything out as a sketch first. Then pick one keyframe as an anchor to develop an offset grid from, somewhere in the center of your wall. With that key piece in place, you can then arrange your other frames around it and continue to add to your gallery as your collection grows. That way you have a flexible system to build from in the future. To break up all the rigid visual lines, we added indoor plants throughout the space. This brought a lot of life to the environment. On the desk surface, we displayed this handsome vintage typewriter we picked up from the flea market a few years ago. It's a gorgeous piece that ended up dictating the style of the rest of the space. To match that modern industrial look, we got this banker's lamp that had a unique mesh cover. Because our accent colors were black and gold, our friends at Provemade sent us these beautiful desk accessories to complete the look. Their products are beautifully designed, a perfect balance of form and function. The last thing we decided to change out was the chair. While Belinda loved the lino chair she had previously used, it just didn't look right in the space. After shopping around, we decided to get this classic Eames Eiffel-style chair in black with wooden legs. To make things extra cozy at night, we added two Philips Hue lamps at the ends of the desk. These smart lights help add ambient lighting to the space when Belinda decides to burn the midnight oil. And that's Belinda's Art Studio workspace. Before we started this project, Belinda wanted to refresh her workspace to suit her changing needs as an artist. After 3 weeks of planning, 6 weekends of work, and many splinters later, we created the perfect setup for her. One that's open, full of sunlight, and allows her to do all the different kinds of projects she's into. I hope by sharing our story here, it might encourage some of you to start your own DIY project. When we first started, we were nervous, intimidated, but excited. We made a ton of mistakes, but learned so much in the process. It wasn't easy, but it was absolutely worth the effort. Finishing this huge project has inspired us to start a few more. If you want to follow along, check out my Instagram, which I update frequently. I want to give a very special thank you to Grovemade for sponsoring this video. I've been using their desk accessories in all of my setups for years because they source high quality materials, have a unique aesthetic, and are always thoughtful in their designs. I did an exclusive interview about this project with the founder of Grovemade, Ken Tomita. He and I chatted about the process behind the project and went deep into the details. Head on over to the link I provided in the description to listen to our conversation and to read more about our collaboration. In other news, I have a very special announcement. I'm launching a new website dedicated to all of my setups, gear, and home projects. I'll be sharing reviews, tutorials, photos, tips, and detailed case studies of great projects like this one. I'll add a link in the description as soon as it's live. In the meantime, you'll find links to everything in the description, including the products, tools, and videos I watched to make this project happen. If you have a question, drop it in the comments, and I'll do my best to answer them. With that out of the way, it's time to get back to work.
So you turned out the best you. Is it possible to be even greater?
You wanna know? Let me show you.
Rise and shine. Track your sleep to know your body's ready. You ready? Let's go get 'em. Move your body. Go, go, go.
Over the past few years, I've been progressively updating based on my changing needs as a creative professional. Recently, big changes have happened. I quit my job and have gone on my own. Because of that, I thought it would be nice to refresh my space for the new endeavors ahead. Hello, I'm Matthew Encina, and in this video, I'll take you through the process of updating my main setup of my home office. Before I begin, I want to thank Benjamin Moore for sponsoring this video and making this possible. This video is part of an ongoing office update series. If you haven't seen the other episodes yet, I'll link them in the description below for you to check out. Stick around till the end to get a preview of what's coming up next. The first part of the project was to plan the layout of my office based on my need. I started by getting the measurements of my room, assessing my workflow needs, and sketching potential layout configurations. Then I built my room in Cinema 4D to get a better sense of volume and what the office would feel like if I moved things around. This design process is something I always go through when I create a new space and is based on three principles: function, flow, and familiarity. I made a whole video about my design and organization process, which I'll link to in the description. Once I settled on a general direction, I started to explore materials, colors, and specific solutions for my needs. As much as I liked having a dark accent wall, I wanted to lighten things up and go for a softer look. I went to my local paint shop and picked up some Benjamin Moore swatches and continued to go.